This should be actually a really interesting match between Rick and Devin. Devin is actually really known for running his tie swarms around here.
He sure is.
And so having Darth Vader with a mini swarm is a fun, good combo. Versus Rick's Han Solo / Luke list, which is another fun thematic combo. So actually, this is a really thematic
It sure is.
List. We were saying just before we got on stream here that if Darth was running with Mahler Mithil and Backstabber, this would be more like a trench run list reenactment. But it's pretty darn close, actually. Now, it looks like we've got one unknown upgrade here on Darth Vader.
Intensity.
Which one is that? Is
that's
that intensity?
That's intensity.
Okay.
Yeah.
It looks like the apparently the software we're using just doesn't have the new upgrades listed in it yet. So Darth Vader here is running Intensity along with Advanced Targeting Computer, Engine Upgrade, TIE X1. So that actually gives him like 3 actions a turn, I think?
Yes.
Because Intensity is whenever you barrel roll or boost, you get a Focus or Evade, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And then you can spend that Focus or Evade to get the Intensity back.
Right.
Right. So that gives him basically 3 actions a turn. And sorry, you were saying?
I'm not certain anymore.
Okay. And then we've got Han over here with VI, homing missiles, Chewbacca, C-3PO, engine upgrade, Falcon. I don't know if that's the old or new Falcon list. I'm betting
this is old. This is old Han.
Yeah, and old Falcon.
Like the original core set.
Yep.
Falcon.
I assume it's the old Falcon title as well.
So this is Fat Han.
Yep, standard Fat Han, and then a Luke Skywalker with VI, seismic torpedo, and R2-D2.
So different. Like, the seismic torpedo is so out there.
Yeah. I mean, it's not a bad idea. I find a lot of people kind of underestimate it or forget that it exists. And the good thing about it is it can actually just clear a hole open in the board, which can make room for Han Solo to maneuver or whatever else.
Yeah. Now, given you probably don't want to give Devin any more space to fly his swarm than you want to.
Mm-hmm.
But if he is close to an asteroid, you can try to pop it for some damage on the TIE Fighters.
Yeah, you get, you know, even if you hit 2 out of 4 of them. I've definitely used it to decent effect in certain lists.
Devin's not going to be flying. Devin doesn't make mistakes with TIE Fighters.
Yeah.
He's going to be flying. He has a ton of reps with TIE Fighters. So it looks like he's setting up in a pinwheel.
Yep. And so just as a reminder for those of you just joining us, so this is an original trilogy tournament. That's why you're seeing these like old school lists here. The basic rules are all the ships have to be ships that appeared in the original trilogy movies, not including the special editions, so no YT-2400 for anybody. So you've got your T-65s, your
Y-Wings, A-Wings,
B-Wings. Y-Wings, A-Wings, B-Wings, the Millennium Falcon. Your TIE Fighters, TIE Advance, TIE Bombers, TIE Interceptors, Lambda Shuttles, Imperial Fire Sprays.
Yep.
That's it. No scum allowed. Every player brings an Imperial and a Rebel list, and when they play against each other, when two people sit down to play, they roll off to see which side they're playing.
As now, you can see, Devin has used his dials before.
Yeah, I was going to say... a
couple games.
You can see how much Devin plays his TIE Fighters with how worn down those dials are. It's impressive. I mean, even this T-65 here is looking pretty worn.
Yeah.
But nothing compared to
I don't know if
Devin's
I've seen
dials.
A dial that worn out before. Look at these things.
I think he needs to get some covers. I don't know. Maybe he likes it that way. It's very intimidating to see dials worn out that much.
Oh, yeah. This is his little mind game smack talk.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, here are my
I have played TIE Fighters before.
I find my personal weakness is swarms. I have a really hard time flying against them. And I don't know what it is or I don't know. It's just, I find them so tricky to fly against.
Well, that's one of the interesting things is in the newer meta, you don't see a lot of crack swarms. You might see some bomber-esque swarms. We have a very, very popular list in Toronto right now called Rush Hour that is 5 TIE bombers.
5 bombers with the shuttle
the Doom
upgrade.
Like a baby Doom shuttle.
One might be a Doom shuttle. But you might have a Doom Shadow. There's a few versions of it. The key, though, is five bombers with tactician. And some have op spec, some have fleet officer, some have systems officer, whatever it is. Just ways to hand out all sorts of mods.
It is a maddening list to fly.
It's so maddening.
This, though, should be interesting. Like, we're seeing some cards that weren't really around during a Fat Han meta. So things like crack shots.
Yeah.
Those TIE fighters that suddenly would never be able to kill Fat Han.
Yep.
Can now push some damage into Han.
It looks like Han started with a K turn.
Yep.
And
which I believe will put Devin into firing.
He's in firing range.
Don't know if he is for everybody though.
Looks like range three for the front three, maybe Vader as well.
Yeah, Vader's in. So Vader's in, four, five are in.
Now, it reminds me that I don't actually remember Luke's exact ability. It is something like...
Yeah, he automatically changes focus results, defensive focus results into evades.
One to an evade?
I think so.
I think it's one. You don't see Luke often. I'll look it up here. X-Wing. That's his spawn roll. Yep. Who is he shooting at? One of the TIE fighters, I imagine. Luke Skywalker, when defending, you may change one focus to an evade. That's a solid ability.
It's true.
But it's a T65, so.
It is. And then Han, of course, you can take any of your dice and just re-roll them once.
Yep. No, isn't it? You can re-roll. You have to re-roll the whole thing.
Yes. Yeah. It's not like a target lock, or it's not like.
It's not a target lock.
And it's not like a predator where you pick up one.
Yeah.
It's everything.
Two hits. Oh, jeez.
Ouch.
Ouch. Now, hitting Han from range three is actually the worst place for Han because he gets that extra die, which means C-3PO is completely ineffective. Well, not completely. It's just harder to be effective with C-3PO. There are those evades.
You know, if Han's not doing any damage back, already plinking a couple shields off of him, not bad.
Not a bad start at all. And that's the thing about these TIE fighters, right? Like, three agility, you got to get close to them to really...
Push that up, yeah.
Push that up, yeah. I assume he's going to be saving the...
Did his Vader get... No, he's focused target... Did he get his target lock off with Darth Vader?
Doesn't look like it. He didn't have a target lock.
Bummer.
I feel like I'm going to need to get a copy of Intensity. Find someone who's bought a lot of aggressors.
Don.
Don bought a lot of aggressors?
Or
Don K?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I'll ask him if he's got an extra one around.
So going back to kind of one of the things that we've recently gotten to see was a four aggressor PS5 TLT swarm.
Yeah, serious.
One of the first things we've seen come out of the new wave. We've seen plenty of other things like Nim Mirandas, etc. But I thought one of the original ones, and it was bound to happen, was a PS5 TLT swarm, which
now,
is different. You know, like it fires a lot earlier than your standard TLT swarm.
Yeah, it covers a lot of. Like, that beats, or that could potentially beat Ryad.
Beats your Skurgs. Fires at the same time as Biggs.
It beats a lot of the low-level Skurgs, although four of them cannot kill a Skurg.
That is true.
The Skurgs have 10.
But you're not likely to pull one off the board, either. They have 5 hit points.
True.
Well, one shield and 4 haul.
Is that right? Yeah. So, I don't know. It's a neat end, and with all that extra agility, they could hang out a lot longer.
It was different. Like, he did well with it, but it's better than I think people will probably think it is, because it was naked besides those TLTs.
Right.
So no frames.
Oh, no frames.
You're literally just
going
for your
PS. Yeah, because you can do frames on the cheaper ones
right.
along TLT, but not on the PS5s. Interesting. Now, what do we do here? Han's going to turn, obviously.
Yep.
He's going to hold on to that stress for a while, unfortunately.
I wonder if you're going to see Devin just turn that swarm. Like, I wonder if he's hoping Rick overplays Luke. Because those ships right now.
Hard ones and twos from all the things, and hard three from Vader, and just have them all facing down. And just
with the idea being that you really shouldn't be chasing Han, right? Like, I mean, it has an engine upgrade. Like, it's going to run.
Yeah, that's true. That's actually not a bad idea. You just hard turn with the whole list, and... what is that?
No,
hard
Devin's
to see? Can't
banking.
See?
Oh, boy.
Oh, he's chasing Han. Interesting. Or is he K-turning?
Now, with that being said, Devin played... he's been playing the game for quite a while. He's actually had to play against this type of fat Han thing, so I'm sure he knows what it can and can't do.
Yeah, it's true. He's also got the crack shots on his side, which is useful. I might save those for Luke, though.
You could rip Luke off the board so fast.
Yeah. I mean, Fat Han is annoying, but C-3PO only works once per round.
Yep. And I'd imagine he probably just did it too hard, three hard maybe. He's actually in a pretty rough spot.
Although there's that Chewbacca crew too. Man, that Han's going to last a while. So the whole list is going after Han. But is Han doing a hard three? But if Han does... this is actually really good. Because no matter what Han does, he's not getting away here.
Right.
Because he's stressed. Because he did a K-turn last turn.
Oh, yeah.
He's trying to boost. Doesn't look like it's going to happen with Vader. So he's just focusing and evading. So not even using intensity, I guess. Right, because you only get that when you boost.
Is he not taking the target lock again?
Yeah, you just focused evade.
I'd admit, I don't know why Devin's not taking that target lock.
Right, because of advanced targeting computer.
Yeah, why wouldn't you just add a crit?
I think maybe he just wants it... maybe he just wants to make sure Vader stays alive?
I think I would take the hit, like at the risk of even taking a shield, because you never have to spend it. Once it's on, you're going to have...
Well, it has
a lot of haul. You usually don't spend it. It just adds that crit result.
That's true. Yeah, you don't spend it. It just adds the crit. So why not hold on to a target lock?
And Han has a lot of haul. Mm-hmm. So you want crits.
Yeah, for sure. Maybe he'll do it next turn. But I don't see why not. Well, this is the thing. Like, Vader's shot isn't going to cause crits this turn because Han still has two shields.
And this is the thing you have to worry about. Now, I've got to say, next round... Devin is likely going to one hard those TIE fighters.
Yep. Yeah, for sure.
And Luke needs to get out of there.
Well, what's Luke doing this turn? Did Luke already move?
Luke already moved.
So just one forward or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so.
So Luke doesn't have, he may have a shot on number three or maybe.
I would consider, it might be crazy, it's probably crazy, for Luke to 4K through the debris next turn.
Yeah.
I'd consider it. You'd end up double stressed. No shot for Luke. Alternatively, three bank just up towards them and hope to get past that block of TIE fighters so that you're behind them for the next turn.
I'd be trucking it. You know, like, I think I would cut through with a really strong, hard move to build up some speed, and even if you take the double stress, then loop around and take your time.
Yeah, maybe.
Because Han can run.
I would consider doing the three bank this way, though, right? Because then if all the TIE fighters turn here, you're past all of them, right?
Yeah.
And in a good spot where they can't turn around to get you easily.
Oh, yeah.
So we've got some more shots on Han. Han whiffs it.
So that should be it for shields on Han, I think.
Yep. Looks like another range three shot.
Yep. So one of the things I know I wanted to see was Devin's Rebel list that we just didn't get to see. He's running the classic, the unknown on Vader is the question. It is intensity.
Intensity, yeah. the EPT from the new TIE Aggressor pack, which lets you, whenever you do a boost or barrel roll, get a free focus or evade. Then you flip it over, and then to flip it back, you need to spend a focus or evade at the end of the combat,
right.
I believe. Which is a really neat card. The reason it says unknown is just our software doesn't have the new the Wave 11 upgrades programmed into it yet.
Wow, so here comes, it's just a lot of fire going into Han.
And that's the thing about swarms, right? They just, against large base ships with low agility, or against low agility ships in general, yeah, sure, they only roll two dice, but they roll two dice four times. And you've got Howl Runner, who's obviously giving you the mods there.
Yeah. And he's already half Han.
Yeah, ooh. Bad news for Han Solo.
And spent a crack shot and not taking any damage back.
Yeah.
Like, that's a rough day.
So where's Luke? That's the real question.
I think I would...
Oh, actually, he's down to three hull, it sounds like. We've miscounted here. Han Solo, not in a good way. Not in a good way at all.
Because I don't really know what you do with Luke. You want to probably do a really hard forward move. You could maybe try to bank in.
I would bank in. Because these guys aren't going to be there later, right? So if you bank in, you might hit...
You still might get some. Like, I don't
know.
Well,
hard one puts them below... Like, puts three below where number five is. So if you one bank, you're behind them.
Yep.
You might get shot by number two, maybe. Yep. Or sorry, not one bank, three bank.
And is it a bad point to get shot? It has R2-D2, right?
Does it have R2-D2?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
I
mean, he does.
This is regen.
Yeah. And then you're in a position to maybe shoot Vader. Well, no, Vader's probably going to gun it. I'm betting Vader's doing a three bank while all the TIEs are doing hard ones.
Yeah.
That's my guess.
I'm wondering if now is going to be the time where Devin takes that target lock, given it's not as necessary now.
Yeah.
He may want to take it on Luke if he's got the opportunity.
That looks like hard ones.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Here it is.
Another common maneuver that Devin's used a few times, as you can see by the quality of that one hard template.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't actually own acrylic templates. I still have my cardboard ones.
I do have acrylics.
And my one straight is worn out like those.
Yeah.
Everything else is almost in pristine condition. I think the one banks are a little worn, too.
So you play some Rebels, is what you're saying.
But I do a lot of barrel rolling, and I play Rebels, yeah. But I'm all about barrel rolling ships all the time. So now, see what I mean? Where the three bank would put him, like, beside...
Yeah, good call.
Three here?
Yep. He'll eat some fire, depending on how he moves Vader.
I think a three bank would make him eat only a shot from number two, depending on what he does with Vader. But I wouldn't be surprised if Vader's doing a three bank here.
And I think that's actually pretty good, because Howl Runner is two, so you're not even getting the reroll.
Hmm. Oh, Vader's doing a one bank. Actually, yeah. If he got that... If he did a three bank here, he would have...
Yeah, here's this. He's lining up a shot on Luke, is what he's hoping for, I think.
Yeah. I'm really hoping for a three bank so Luke gets a range one shot of Vader.
Intensity?
Yep. So he pulled off intensity to get a free focus.
And a target lock. He got the target lock, is what he went for. Makes sense.
So barrel roll, focus... Oh, sorry, barrel roll plus target lock, free focus from intensity. And that is... Hard two.
Oh, boy.
Weird choice.
Oh, man, he's going to eat.
Yeah, I totally would have three banked.
Yeah.
Because see where he'd be with the three bank?
Oh, yeah.
He might get shot from number two.
Maybe, not even. Like, he might just get a free shot in on Vader. You may hit.
I think Vader would have had a shot. Actually, Vader might not have even had a shot. He might have been
outside. It would have been a good move.
It would have been the right move. For sure. And
hindsight,
then,
we're not playing. Like,
No, yeah. Of course. I mean, obviously things look different when you're on at the table.
Luke is not going to do well this round.
I wouldn't be surprised if both ships die this turn. Like, if Devin manages to just kill everything. Right? Luke gets a shot, sure. He's not going to kill any of these guys. V Vader kills Vader and one of the TIE fighters could potentially kill Luke.
That's a good call by Rick, not boosting. I'd be baiting Han right now, hoping people shoot him, because Luke can get deleted.
Yeah. But no, I would totally take the opportunity to kill Luke here.
Yes. Me
kill
too.
Han later. You've already got half points on Han.
Yeah, I would not be doing this. I would be baiting more shots into Han.
At the very least, you want to be able to shoot Han, shoot with Han. You can't just run forever.
Because I think
that's the thing that people, when you run turrets,
or bait with Fen Rao.
Yeah.
A lot of people do that with Fen Rao, where they run the entire time. That's an expensive piece of bait.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, if you want to shoot, you have to be in range to be shot at.
Spend the focus. Does it take one? Actually, did. Yeah, he's just gonna take the damage to shoot back.
Yep, that makes sense.
Yeah.
So number five's taking one damage, but he's still got crack. Like, oof, he's in a bad way.
I also think Luke.
This isn't how the movie goes.
Yeah, I don't think the terrorists are going to eke this one out.
Yeah, no. So Echo's here, for those of you on the Twitch chat, don't see this. It says, this isn't how the movie goes, with a very concerned-looking emoji. this is not how the movie goes.
And Luke deletes one.
Oh, Luke deletes a TIE fighter. Very nice. Yeah. That's good news. But imagine that was up at Vader instead, right?
Yep, and like, it's still not Howl Runner.
Yeah. Why didn't he shoot Howl Runner?
I don't know.
Because that was range one to all of them.
Yeah.
That doesn't make sense. I would have shot Howl Runner.
Oh, Vader's range two. That's
Although,
good.
Howl Runner's ability... Does Howl Runner's ability include Howl Runner?
No.
Is it only friendly?
It's friendlies.
Well, then maybe not shooting Howl Runner's a bad... not a terrible idea. Two hits, ATC, so three hits on Luke, who blanks out.
Ouch.
Oh, yep. No. Not even a focus. So that brings Luke down to... Luke takes a direct hit.
Ouch. So
Luke has one
his...
health left. Oh, God.
Oh, man. He doesn't have...
And
I'd assume he has integrated.
No. Wait, what?
Why? Yes, he does.
He's
There's
gotta
no
have
way
integrated.
He doesn't have integrated. He has integrated.
He's got to have integrated.
He doesn't have auto thrusters on Luke, does he?
Oh, but Crackshot pumps that one through.
Well, we'll see. No, he did not have integrated.
How do you not have integrated?
So Rick must be running auto thrusters.
No, but he's got nothing on him other than VI, Seismic, and R2-D2.
Hold on, I'm going to double check that. He does have it.
Oh, okay. So I'd even... Right. That's different. Like, he took a direct hit. I thought he was going to... Mike just went to check on it.
He does indeed have integrated.
Did he just pick it up too early?
I think he just picked it up too early. But he does indeed have integrated. He's actually using the new store kit card,
yeah,
the R2-D2 integrated astromech card. It's really kind of neat.
Yeah, playing against Devin.
I wonder if they can hear. They should not be able to hear us over here. Hopefully not.
There's a lot of background noise. I'm sure it's okay.
And there's another crack shot.
So I'd assume he's down to maybe a hull or two. Oh, that went to get in a crit, too. Major hull breach.
Yeah, I mean, Han Solo doesn't survive this, right? Maybe if they didn't have crack shots.
Yeah, Chewbacca.
He's going to use Chewbacca, so he gets a health and a crit and a shield back.
Yeah.
No, sorry, he cancels the damage and gets a shield back?
Yeah, he cancels the damage and gets a shield
back. Yeah, that's how that works. Chewbacca, great card. 4 points for two effective hull, or two effective health. Better than shield upgrade or hull upgrade, that's for sure.
I love the comment by Erase. Remember in the first movie when Luke Skywalker dies? What a plot twist that was. Yeah, this isn't great. Turns out the Force, it does not protect you from parking yourself range one in front of a crack swarm.
No. I mean, that hard two was easily the wrong choice.
Oh, yeah.
A three bank would have been... He would have taken, again, maybe two shots. One from Vader, one from the other guy.
Well,
he might still have died.
Maybe. It would have set up the idea, though, that you would then have one ship behind and you have to chase the Falcon.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you wanted to turn your swarm around, then the Falcon would be at your back.
Yeah.
Like, you would control...
Yeah, and I think that's how you have to handle swarms, is to keep your ships separated.
You have to, yeah.
And come at them from different directions. Because either they start looking in different directions and lose their cohesiveness, which
yep.
is what makes swarms so good, or they just pick one target, and sure, that one target's going to die. But in the meantime, your other targets are going to destroy them from behind.
Right.
In theory. That being said, he's got Vader here to act as a pincer of his own, right? Like, the swarm can run in a block while Vader can go around picking people off who decide to run away from the swarm.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, it's just an uphill battle at this
yeah.
point, right? Like, he should be able to chip this down. He spent Chewbacca.
He only has to do 4 damage to Han. This is so tough. I would actually probably just have... I mean,
one forward.
One forward or have K-turned.
Yeah.
One forward keeps them in range, though. There's that target lock. Yep.
Yeah, there we go.
He's finally remembering to take those target locks. He gets his evade. And what do? One forward, or do you just, like, K-turn with Han? Is that a three bank? Or a hard three?
You could try to run hard. Yeah.
I don't know what he's doing. He keeps taking his ships and running them in front of the swarms. A one forward would have been pretty sweet, at least for that one turn.
Yeah.
And then if you decide to turn back, you could then go out.
And this is bad, but not terrible. He's not eating that many shots back.
I think
now he might be out of range from Vader. I think
yeah.
Vader barely ticked him in range.
About two might not have arc. Five and
it's
four
not that bad.
Do. Which
like,
one's which one's Howl Runner? Two? That's two?
Two.
Yeah, that's Howl Runner. Are we sure?
Yep. Yeah, I see an eight. Yeah.
Oh, he took an evade or focus? That's what the old title does. I keep forgetting that.
Gives you the evade action.
Evade action, yeah. That looks like range three. Oh, you nudged him. It's range three.
Yeah, and you can see he has his Inquisitor range ruler, is what that one was.
Hmm?
Oh, Devin just pulled out his Inquisitor range ruler, where it just says one on it.
Oh, no, triple evades from that TIE fighter.
Man. They are a maddening ship to fight every once in a while.
TIE fighters?
Yeah.
I don't fly against them often. I don't see it often.
It's just the variance, right?
Yeah.
Like, sometimes you just can't hit them, and other times they just blank out and die in a ball of fire immediately. So it looks like that did nothing at the moment, which is exactly what Rick wants.
Mm-hmm.
Ouch.
That's two more hits on Han Solo.
I would put
Lone Wolf in this list. Rather than VI on Han?
I don't know if Han needs to be up to 11.
No.
You're already running a 10. If anything, then I would have put Lone Wolf on Luke. You don't need an 11 and a 10.
No.
And a
no.
list.
Lone Wolf on Han would be pretty sweet. Reroll those dice. Actually, it's great when you call 0 with C-3PO. You get the 1.
Yep.
Free evade when you roll a 0. Then you reroll it and get another 1,
yep.
potentially.
Lone Wolf on Luke is excellent. Because
yeah.
it lets you reroll the blank. As long as you roll a focus, you get that focus into
yeah.
an evade.
Yep.
With their, people are going to tend to target Han.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, unless you
well,
lay
that's the thing.
Luke
if
out
you,
there.
If you do put Lone Wolf on Han, suddenly he's that much tankier, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Actually, I might play around with that sometime soon. And then Lone Wolf acts kind of like Predator does with people. Because some people like using Predator on Han.
It's not a bad call right now, even in the new the newer meta.
I've been trying
lots
to think
of,
trying to think of how to run a good old Han list.
That's the type of ship that does really well against things that have TLTs. That'll do nice against Nim.
Yeah. I never actually owned the original Falcon,
nope.
But I was able to get from someone who did own the original Falcon all the tiles and cards.
Nice.
So, I mean, I'll never run two Falcons, but I've got the Heroes of the Resistance one, so it's fine. So, an old Han, though, with Lone Wolf, C-3PO.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I would run it.
Like this, but with Lone Wolf.
Maybe without homing missiles. I don't know if you need homing missiles either. Actually, that would maybe take a look at an Intensity Poe. You might have enough points for that to throw a Fat Han Poe.
Let's see. So, Old Han. And your play... Nope. This one here.
The YT, to answer their question on what shot does the YT have at this point, none.
Well, although... Oh, no. See, here's the thing. He's going to do a one forward, or whatever he does, he's trapped now, right? Like, he's going to end up in that kill box again.
Yeah. Go fast and boost
this
to
is
try
where,
to get as much range as you can.
This is where inertial dampeners would be fantastic, right?
Ouch.
What are you
that
doing?
Is not what I would do either.
No, you go the other way.
A straight would have been the right thing.
Straight leads you into the rock, but even just the other way and then a boost.
I would have done four forward.
Oh, maybe he's going to try and... Because now if you boost bank towards...
No,
you still end up in arc...
No, I played a fair amount of Rack. That's, no, it's not good.
So, Han, Lone Wolf, C-3PO. I'm just making a list here while we watch this happen. Gunner.
Oh,
not Chewbacca, but Gunner. No, not Tail Gunner.
That range ones, too. Just adds that extra little bit.
I mean, there's no way he's going to survive this, right?
Delete Halorunner, maybe.
It's the only option.
Well, I mean, it's not going to save him, but
no,
can
because
Halorunner.
Vader's right there.
Yeah, Vader's going to munch him up.
It's a hit and two crits.
It's good. Ouch, that doesn't. And so he takes a crit.
Halorunner does?
Yep.
That could be a thing. Damage engine.
So
which
all
is,
hard turns are red?
Oh, no.
Not going to matter at this point.
No.
That is typically a nice one to see on a TIE fighter. It's just not going to matter.
So this is Vader's shot?
Yes. Yeah.
And that is game, right?
That is classic what Vader pumps in.
I think the only thing he can do here is call one on C-3PO and hope he rolls the evade. But then he only blocks two. He got it. So he takes one crit and watch it be a direct hit. Direct hit.
Direct hit.
Is
and
that
that's game.
That's good
yep.
game.
That is game.
Well, there we go, ladies and gentlemen. Devin Monkhouse's TIE Swarm just destroyed Han and Luke. It was a good game, but I think Rick made a few big mistakes
yep.
turning Luke into that swarm there rather than trying to get past him. Just was not the right choice.
Right.
There you go.
Swarms can be great.
Yep, swarms can be great, and especially in the hands of someone like Devin who really knows how to fly them. Great. So thanks everyone for watching. Once again, this is the 401 Games Original Trilogy Tournament brought to you by 401 Games and also by many people here in the PTL, Prototype Toronto League, and by VTT Live, VTTV Live, who are the ones who are doing the streaming for us. If you guys want to see more local Toronto games, you can check out the VTTV Live YouTube channel where we posted some of our previous streams, previous games, including our recent finals for our recent PTL season. So feel free to go check out those videos while you wait. We'll be back in about 40-45 minutes.
Yep. Thanks, everybody.
All right, everyone, welcome back. This is actually, we've got a bit of a surprise here for you. Devin and Rick, who you just saw playing on the stream, have decided they want to switch it up and try their opposite lists. So Devin's going to play his Rebel list, Rick's going to play his Imperial list, just as a bit of a friendly exhibition game. Since we do have 40 minutes to kill, and they wanted to try out their other lists, they figure, why not? So we're just going to put this up here for you guys to watch while we wait for the next round to start. So right now, Devin is loading up his quintuple Y-Wing list. That's 5 Y-Wings, all with autoblaster turrets. And I think that's it. Yep, 5 Y-Wings with autoblaster turrets. So that's not something you'll see very often. And Rick's got a... Interceptor list, I believe it is. Let's see what we got. We've got Howl Runner with Swarm Tactics and 2 Saber Squadrons with Trick Shot and 2, what is this, Alpha Squadron? What am I looking at here? Yeah. So SCF, they've just flipped just for an exhibition game. So the first game you watched was their official game, but they decided just for fun, because they've got 40 minutes, that they will play a little exhibition game. So we've just got that up and running for you guys here.
Are we gonna see the impromptu match?
Yeah. So my name is Mike, by the way, just for all you guys following along.
Everything good? You got our list?
This is Steven here. Devin's hanging around, and he's about to go play against Rick. Just in a quick exhibition match while we run out the clock for the next round.
Because
why not? Let's see. We really wanted to see this match, actually. When they started the match, they rolled off to see who would play Imperials, who would play Rebels. And it turned out that
5 Y-Wings, all with auto blaster turrets.
Yep. So I see Feek, it's 5 Y-Wings with auto blasters. As opposed to 4 TLT Y-Wings, TLT being banned in this tournament. It's the only one upgrade that is banned. Once again, this is what we have. It's just Devin versus Rick. They've decided to play an exhibition using their opposite faction squads because they didn't get to play these ones, and we really wanted to see these on stream. So this one is just for fun, doesn't count for the tournament. But I'm really curious, actually, to see how 5 auto blaster Y-Wings work out compared to, say, 4 TLT Y-Wings.
And look at this. We've got Rick flying Howl Runner with Swarm Tactics.
Yeah.
Saber Squadron with Trick Shot. Another Saber Squadron with Trick Shot. An Avenger Squadron.
And an Alpha Squadron.
And an Alpha Squadron.
I wonder if that PS3 is really worth it. I would probably take another Alpha Squadron.
I think so too.
Just to have 2 more points to throw on Howl Runner? Maybe? I don't know what I would put on Howl Runner.
No, I think that's the thing. I don't know what I would do. Because then you could potentially do, let's see.
A stealth device on Howl Runner? No, stealth device is 3?
Well, this is Swarm Tactics. I'd want the Swarm Leader. Where you can pull their evades for a power shot.
It's not really that great on Howl Runner, though. You really want that on someone who's got 3 attack dice native. But you could put
Saber
it on
squadron.
One of the Saber Squadrons. You could totally put on one of the Saber Squadrons. And it looks like they're just moving. They're playing a little fast and loose with initiative and stuff right now. So just because they're low on time and stuff, they just want to kind of play this for fun. So you'll probably see some pretty loose maneuvers here as well. Here go those.
This is just going to be a game on how well Rick can control range, to be honest.
How well Rick can control range. That's the thing. These Y-Wings have no repositioning.
Right.
But they do have that auto blaster turret. And I was talking to Devin about this list earlier. I think what you really want to do is spread them out so that there's no safe place to be.
Right.
And you just take, you know, a couple auto blaster shots here or there. Trying to get all 5 auto blaster shots on one target's not going to happen. So flying them in a block is probably more dangerous, more dangerous for you as a player than flying them in a wide area in a net.
To be fair here, Rick's list is punchy. Mm-hmm. Right? I mean, you've got three dice in from all of those interceptors.
Yep, that's you know, 12 dice follow, with free rerolls from Hellrunner.
Yeah, not bad.
Mm-hmm.
So it's one of those things where those Y-Wings can certainly rip an interceptor off the board without too much problem, but unless he gets in the right range, those interceptors are going to lay damage into those Y-Wings very, very quickly.
We were just thinking about lists after seeing that Han I was thinking about in the previous game, thinking about some lists. I'm thinking I might try old Han with Nim, Rebel Nim, see how that goes.
It's a chunky list.
Yeah, I haven't actually flown old Han much, so we'll see how that goes. Maybe I'll make that one of my first PTL match in the new season.
Yeah, which I think comes up in August for us. This is just an exhibition match, yes.
Yep, just an exhibition while we wait for the round to end, guys.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
Yep, this is going to be interesting. And so you see how they're being a little fast with the maneuvers, not super precise.
Yeah, super quick.
Now, Rick was telling us just while we were offline for a few minutes there that he's actually more comfortable with Imperials in general than he is with Rebels. So that's why he felt he was making some of those mistakes in the previous match. But it'll be interesting to see him flying his Imperials now. And an Interceptor Swarm is something you just never see.
I like it. It's pretty interesting.
It is. I think it's...
Like, that's a lot of guns coming in.
Yep. I'm all about, like, lots of three dice attacks.
I mean, to be honest, as long as Rick just keeps this pace kind of slow, he is going to unload.
Yeah.
On a Y-Wing.
He's got to get close eventually. And that's the challenge Devin has, is someone took two hits. Number one took two hits.
I don't know.
Probably.
Devin's a big boy. I'll figure it out. Or not.
Yeah, like, you want to catch a net and force him to come to you. Force the...
I wonder if Howlrunner was the right... I wouldn't want to fly these interceptors in formation. I'd want to break these out into, like, twos.
Yeah.
Or at least... Or just completely spread and use their maneuverability.
Yeah, would you split them up? Would you?
I think so. I mean, I think I would probably save the points from Howlrunner and turn it into four. You can run the eights list with interceptors.
Oh, were they all eights?
Yes.
Who's
that? Adaptability. You do the top Royal Guard pilot. You do the all generics.
Is it PS7?
I think so.
Generic? Really?
It'll VI them.
Or is it PS6?
So it's PS6 and you throw the title and you just take VI on all of them to bring them to 8.
There's a PS... Oh, wow. That could be fun.
Yeah, there is a PS6 generic.
Huh.
He is the...
How many points?
Royal Guard pilot at 22.
That still gives you... So four of them...
You can...
Four of them with Predator.
I mean, you go...
Leave him a PS6 and just give him Predator. That way you can focus or barrel roll as you need to, you just get your rerolls.
1 point in, you could take a 1 point in thrusters on every single one of them.
Auto thrusters?
Yeah, run crack shots and auto thrusters.
Oh, yeah. That could be pretty good.
Or bump them to 8.
Yep. Also not a bad idea. Although I think...
At adaptability, you can run 2 EPTs on... No, that's 2 mods is what it gives you, right? What is
Yeah,
the
2 mods.
Okay. That's less good. I want the A-Wing ability.
Hmm.
Because then you could run like adaptability crack shot.
Yeah, but thrusters. Adaptability, excuse me, plus auto thrusters. Are there any other good mods? Like cheap mods? Not really.
No.
Guidance chips.
Yeah, none. Your disrespect mods. You can just throw guidance chips on stuff for fun.
Now, what do you do with Devin as Devin here? I would be trying to get as close as possible, but knowing that the swarm isn't going to get close enough to you this turn, right?
Yeah. I would be setting myself up so I could hard turn. Like, I would be going slow, but putting myself into spots where I could hard turn.
Okay,
and just
I was about to say.
Except you're going to eat shots, but you've got enough hit points.
So, three bank from number four. I'm betting three is going to do a hard two.
Right.
Five is probably just going to do a one straight and stay back so that he can be.
Exactly.
See, there we go. Staying back so that next turn.
Almost like we've seen Devin fly a few times.
Well, I mean, this is how I would fly this list, right? Making sure that they're kind of far apart from each other. You don't want them in a block. There's the hard two. One is going to...
Just these little overlapping arcs of range one.
Yeah, overlapping blocks, right?
Because he's not
one isn't getting anywhere, so he's just doing, he's going that way.
Get some distance.
Yep. And then two, I'm betting three bank, maybe. No, nope, hard two. Okay,
so he's going for more of like just a staggered three and two and back.
Yeah, exactly. Keep some alive, have some take shots. And actually, if he plays it really smart, next turn he can move these guys past the interceptors and then bring in the two undamaged ones.
Yep.
Right?
And the other thing is we have to remember, these interceptors can't go slow.
Yep.
Devin can just start doing one forwards and just gum up this huge block.
Yep.
Like now Rick's got to deal with rocks.
Yep.
All over the place. He's going to unload this round and could strip a lot, and he needs this to kind of pay off.
I don't think it matters so much. They're all.
Oh, fair point.
No. Because where they both ended up, it was fine. Yeah. Sometimes you just do it in the other order because they both did the same maneuver, so.
You're right, though. If this were closer, like, and this was an actual tournament game, how he activates is a big thing. See, this is the thing, though. He doesn't care about debris. Like, you just park that one right on it.
Yep. So one of these three dice attacks with rerolls and focuses on some of them.
It's going to be dirty. Number three is going to get...
I don't think Devin's going to lose one this turn.
Well,
he might lose number three.
Yeah.
Maybe.
He obviously has to focus fire. And Rick needs his unmodified interceptor to pull some work.
Yeah.
Like, that's going to have to be a little out of variance. You're hoping for a good roll.
Yeah. I mean, three might die, but he needs solid rolls every roll to really make that work. Who was this? This was an interceptor, not Hellrunner? Not off to a good start.
Just one.
Number three's taking one. That's Hellrunner. Did they forget Hellrunner the first time?
Yeah, Hellrunner should have shot first.
Yeah. No trick shot, though. Four dice. No focus. Just one hit. Yeah, so that guy's going to survive. And
with a nice amount of health, too.
And these interceptors are going to eat some auto blaster fire.
A little bit, right? Next round might get really bad. Like, how he starts playing into this like little scrum in the middle, that's what's going to make this match.
Yeah. Oh, there's another fairly poor roll. Three, one evades, so number three takes two hits.
So he's out of shields, I think.
Yeah, number three's out of shields, but number three lives this round. And then
Hopefully. Next
turn, you just move for some bumps, and then...
Oh, you just start doing one banks at this point.
Yeah. Like, who cares if you bump?
You've got a little pinwheel of death. Yeah. Know, like.
Like, five's going to bank in, one's going to hard two.
Two
should hard two here so as to block the escape out that way. Someone took a direct hit. On number three?
Yeah, it's fine.
So he's down to two hull left.
Yeah.
This is a gross list.
Auto blaster. Yeah, here comes that.
Oh, just
that's
one
not
crit.
What you wanted. Nope, you can defend against a crit. You can actually roll against a crit.
Yep.
That's the exact opposite of what you wanted to say.
So, another, some more auto blasters. No evades. There's one hit. So, number three takes one hit.
That's the thing. I don't know what range one. He has no tokens. You may have wanted to just pump your primary into him.
True.
Because you're going three into
but
three.
But he also had no tokens, so I think the auto blaster is actually the better choice there. I think you shoot. Who's he shooting?
Number two. He's on a piece of debris. Somebody with no action.
So what's going on here? Two crits? What? Who will just roll two crits?
Two evades.
Oh, that was looked like a primary shot.
Oh no.
Who took a crit?
One of the interceptors.
Yep, another range three shot. Blanks.
Bummer.
I mean, if these guys were TLTs, they'd be clinking away.
This, I think, is going to be... this would be done. Like, a TLT would be absolute murder against this list. It doesn't have auto thrusters.
Right. Yeah.
You've only got three hull. That's going to be terrible.
When in a meta where you know TLT is going to be a thing, though, you get auto thrusters. Right?
Yes.
Like.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the thing. Like, some of these lists couldn't exist without these restrictions.
Yeah. So once again, for those of you tuning in, the restrictions currently are no TLT, and all the ships must have appeared in the original trilogy, original versions, not the special edition, which includes the YT-2400. So no YT-2400. So you've got Falcons, A-Wings, Y-Wings, B-Wings, X-Wings, Lambda Shuttle, Fire Spray, TIE Fighter, TIE Advance, TIE Bomber, TIE Interceptor.
Right.
Those are the only ships allowed in this tournament. Any pilot you want, so that includes new pilots for the old ships, such as, like, Rey for the Falcon, but it has to be the old chassis.
This is the critical turn.
Yeah. So what do you do? One forward with the three, hard two.
I mean, you could hard two with this one and one forward with that one.
Yeah, you could, actually. Hard two with the three, one forward with the two,
yep.
One bank with the four, two bank with the five,
block
hard
it.
Two with the one.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Gum it up.
Just gum up the whole thing.
The thing is, if he hard turns away, he's going to be eating a ton of shots.
Yep. It's a scary list.
It is.
It's a very scary list.
I feel like in this one, he's now kind of at the point where he wanted to delete ships in the last round and did not.
He got that gold squadron down to two health, but that is not enough.
No.
If he had gotten down to zero, he'd be in a much better spot. That being said, he can still take one out this turn. He can still take out number three this turn, but that means he's not taking out another one this turn. Right?
This is still super winnable. Yeah. This is just one of these matches that if you're Rick, you've got to play it super careful.
Yeah. Okay, right. Because that one moves first, which means doing the three is not necessarily a good idea.
I'll put it on a rock. And
like
to
hit the rock. Ouch.
And the thing is, with the auto blaster turret, Devin doesn't care as much about actions.
No.
You know, like, he's just rolling the two dice. If it hits, you take damage.
Yep. That is a direct hit.
Ouch.
On our Alpha Squadron pilot.
So he's down to one.
Ooh, excuse me.
Devin's trying to get creative with marking
doing?
Ships, bumping.
Is
I think he dialed
or
in.
Is he, no, he's trying to move that guy out. So did he three bank or hard three or something?
I thought he dialed
something?
In a two hard.
Trying to get past that guy? Oh, hard three.
Jeez.
Wow. Does he? Oh, yeah, he totally makes that. He bumps into the Alpha, but the Saber, I think that is, just fine. People underestimate that, the hard three with the Y-Wing.
Now I think this number two might just want to one bank in this case and just come in and just be a pain.
No, just
one
the one straight.
Fine.
Yep. Just come up the works.
The only thing I see that's a problem with that, now, reason why I may not have done a one bank, is he can two hard now with some of this and get out of there.
Yeah. But if he two hards, but then he has to boost to avoid the shots.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
So this guy goes there. So five's definitely doing a hard two, or no.
Two bank, one bank. It depends on how.
Actually,
like,
I would do one bank.
I don't think I would be playing, like, he's playing this really aggressively.
Yeah.
I think I would have played it more of like a slow pinwheel kind of thing, where you just.
Actually, that's really good. Three bank, because if number two here is hard twoing away, he might be able to boost at a range one, maybe. But maybe not.
I think he's in a lot of trouble.
I love this number one here is just for backup. That is
a
that
lot.
Is a clusterfuck of a
I mean, this is where
situation.
You sit there and when he's gonna and Rick's gonna start flipping his dials, you're like, how are we gonna mark this and actually set these down? And that's the tough thing when you're playing against so I recently played against the TIE Swarm a couple games with the four-ship Rebel list. And you spent most of the game marking ships and bumping.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you don't even, like, you get as much fewer turns in than I think you realize, because a lot of the things turn into bumping. And the beginning of the bumps have happened. And the question on this is do you even want to not bump? Right?
That guy
because
just
put himself on a rock.
Put himself on a rock rather than get caught.
He's still going to get auto-blastered.
Yeah, because he can't boost away.
And that's what I was thinking. You may just want to self-bump yourself and get as many guns as you can.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Because this eliminates a three-dice gun.
Yep. He can't shoot first. And four-dice at range one.
Right. You may have just wanted to buy into it and see if you get out damage one and start pulling. Like, you've got the PS on some of them. Just see if you can't start pulling the Y-Wings.
Mm-hmm.
And understand your agility is not going to save you. It's a straight damage race. Because you've still got HAL rerolls. Like, you'll throw in consistent hard damage.
Excuse me. There's that self-bump. That's the thing. He's not getting many shots this turn.
No.
Number five's going to take some. Oof.
Well, number five doesn't get to shoot. He's on a rock.
No.
Number three is on a rock.
Rebel five.
Oh, yeah.
He's going to take.
Rebel five's at high, like gold five's at full health. Like, damage up. Number three is the one that's hurt. He might die. Hellrunner might get him.
Maybe.
You hope.
Oh,
he's
I mean, three
two.
Dice unmodified versus one die unmodified. There's a good chance of doing two hits.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you'll
a good chance
out
of not
two.
Doing two hits.
Exactly. You're averaging to 1.5.
Is that right? Let's see. I've actually got a probability calculator on my phone. Three dice, no modified, versus one dice, no modified. Expected number of hits, 1.17. So it's
still
actually
alive, but maybe
a much better chance of getting one than two.
Right.
Yeah. Who's shooting here? Again, what, did they not do Hellrunner shot? So number five took two hits.
I don't know. They're swarm tacticking up.
Right. Swarm tactics.
They're flipping their PS. Got it. It
brings someone up, right? It brings one guy up.
You swap your PS.
I don't think it swaps. I think it just makes the other guy PS yours.
Yeah, maybe.
Decoy is the one that swaps PS. Two hits. One evade on... Who took one?
Number two?
Hmm.
Maybe? Number five? I don't know, actually, who took that.
All right, so auto blasters into Hellrunner.
Ouch.
How Runner Takes Two. Oh.
That's what you don't want to start seeing.
Nope.
Devin's like, how much can I squeeze this range one? I think that one's actually in range one.
Oh, yep. Number four is shooting Howlrunner. Focus for two hits. Howlrunner is dead.
Boom.
Boom. Now, he's still got three more auto blaster shots. Number one here can shoot the guy on the rock. I would do that now because I know that's the only shot he can take.
Boy, that's brutal.
Like, I mean, you might as well do the ones first that are the only shots you can do, right?
And the thing is now since he's got him in this pinwheel,
you can just circle around him. Yeah. No, activate this guy first.
Measure it, at least.
Well, because if this guy doesn't need to shoot, if number three dies because of number one shot, then,
yeah,
then you can choose.
Number
where
one
to
can
do,
only shoot him.
Yeah, exactly.
Crit.
Two crits coming from. I don't know who's shooting who here.
Oh, he just. Somebody took a crit, I think.
Yeah. Shaken Pilot, I thought that was.
That's pretty quick. I didn't catch it.
Oh, whoever it was, he died.
Well, Howrunner's dead. And Alpha's.
Oh, that was the one on the rock.
Dead. Yeah, that's what it was. It was the one on the rock.
Oh, now everyone else is going to shoot. No, but again, start with number one, because if one kills him...
Yes, you could potentially shoot two.
Yeah, exactly. Right. I don't know what he's doing.
Caught it. I think he's out. No, he is now. Actually, no, that's
no, that was range one. That's range one for sure. Two hits on number three.
He's dead? I thought he took a damage on that rock. He must not have.
No, but he's down to two health. Or whatever. But yeah, that's how you do that. You should have done that first, so as to make number five
could shoot into two.
Have choices, right? Yeah.
Right, he did.
You always do the ones that don't have choices first, because otherwise you might just end up wasting a shot.
This is just a murder, though.
I wonder how a list like this would fare in a much larger. It's what, 8 times 5. 40 hull?
Yeah.
40 hull. And 40 hit points, massive damage. As long as you fly it, right?
You know, it's kind of a similar idea to what Rush Hour is doing.
Yeah.
Where it's just a lot of fairly chunky ships that you're not going to be prepared to fly against. Nobody's going to get reps against 5 gold squadrons with auto blasters.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're going to go in
and go,
you'll do fantastic against some stuff. But the stuff that you wouldn't do fantastic about, you hope they just panic and don't fly it right.
Yeah, exactly. And Rush Hour, by the way, is a list that's been popularized here, which is 5 bombers, 5 TIE bombers, all with the shuttle upgrade, all running tactician, and then a few other random crew, like op spec or fleet officer or intel agent or whatever else.
A Doom Canoe.
Or Vader. Yeah. But the key is 5 bombers with tactician.
And it is dirty.
It is dirty.
Yeah, it's not a nice list.
No, not a nice list.
I've flown it once and actually beat it, but it was very, 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 very frustrating.
Mm-hmm.
It was actually Devin flying it. I didn't play Christian.
Yeah, Christian, who's the one we came up with it.
But this is...
It's one thing I really enjoy about the Toronto meta here.
Fun.
It's fun in that there are a lot of people trying out crazy things. It's not much, especially with PTL, our league, which forces players to... try different things each game.
And that thing is down to one hull. I think that gold just took another damage.
Yeah, he took a hit going over the rock. So the people around here are always trying random new things.
Yeah.
Like, what random thing can I try? And not to say that there aren't creative communities elsewhere and stuff. I just noticed that it's really creative here.
In huge numbers of people, right?
Yeah, and maybe you don't see that. Maybe I've just, my perspective is I don't see that in other communities because I'm only seeing what's being posted on Reddit.
Right.
Or, you know, like the Nova Squadron Facebook group or whatever, and people are posting their meta lists.
But I don't think we get a lot of, though we can eventually come up with the meta lists, I feel like a lot of our players, we don't tend to get the meta from Reddit.
Yeah.
There are enough people here that are at, you know, extremely high levels of play
that
will see the meta list at the same time as everyone else.
Yeah, exactly.
Our upgrades might be a little different, but like the general idea and the general themes seem to stay.
Yeah, it's a really good community. Good players doing fun stuff. But whoo, boy, I feel bad for Rick again.
Is this thing's just gonna go slow? Too hard. He actually went faster than I would.
No, but this blocks the interceptor on the debris here from getting.
Yeah.
I hope he did a three bank or something.
He could do it too hard.
Yeah, hard too. But even then,
he's still gonna eat two auto blaster turrets.
Right.
Though.
Well, you boost, I guess, is the only thing you can do. But even then, a boost wouldn't get you out of way.
And that's exactly what we're seeing.
Yeah. Is that a two hard?
Yeah. Yep. I don't think a boost is gonna clear both. I would boost that way if you're gonna boost anyway. I don't
barrel
think that
doesn't help. A boost, a bank boost to the south, to the bottom of the screen here.
Maybe, yeah.
Is your only option. And hope to be out of range one. I'm pretty sure you still end up in range one of number five here, though.
Yeah, and I feel like Devin, as he gets, if he plays this more, he could use a little more space on this list.
Yeah.
Like, he's still a
keeping
little
them really
more
close.
Clumped.
And the problem with that is, if Rick were able to get away...
you can quickly really spank the Y-Wings. Like, that's the, if you're good at controlling range and really skirt them, they've only got that range one is real fire.
Yeah, you should not have let this happen. You should have just...
Gone around. Just done a couple hard turns in.
Yeah, I mean, easier said than done.
Flying in formation might have been one of the first mistakes, too. Like,
yeah, deciding to stick in the formation. Because a formation means you want to be in a block, which means you're very susceptible to bumps.
And he wants you to be in a block.
Yeah, if you're in a block, you can just, like, gum it up and auto-blast away.
Yeah, I mean, look at this. Like, he's going to try to boost out and... I just don't know if it matters.
A boost might save his bum.
Save it from number two.
Number four here needs to boost.
Goes that way if you can.
Not straight. I would bank.
I would have two.
But then you're facing the rock.
I still think I would.
Yeah.
Because I think he's still going to be in range. Well, he's definitely in range one of three.
Of three and four.
Yeah.
Not number one. Maybe two.
Number one might have range one on.
I think number. Five might have range one on two. I guess we'll see. We will see. All right, auto blast turret. Focus.
He's really rolling a lot of crits.
Yeah, that's been kind of weird. Well, crit evaded. That's always a shame. That's another range one shot.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's in for sure. Focus for two hits. Number four takes two hits.
Pop.
Nope, number four still has one shield or one hull left.
Sorry, I was looking at PS4.
Yeah. So he's down to one hull. I think they're debating. What's going on here? Oh, it looks like number two made it out of range.
Nice.
So number four should be at one hull left. And he got no shots that turn at all.
No.
This is a gross list. I mean, what would I fly to counter this? That's what I'm trying to figure out.
TLT. Chew this up. Primary weapon turrets to run, like a fat Han.
Oh, yeah,
great
fat
against
Han.
This.
Yeah.
Rack would be really good. Stuff to just run.
Yeah. Like the key would be with the Y-Wings to be spreading them out more. right? So you can't run. That you're always going to be within range of one or two of them.
An alpha list would do really well because you could pull
take
a couple.
Off one.
Yeah, like all you're going to have to do is pull a couple, so it just opens up where you can fly, and then you could be okay.
Yeah.
Like double ghost would be kind of funny. Like you just chunk into them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, any of your PS0 ships I think would do well against this because then you don't care about agility anyway. Like,
yeah.
Realistically,
yeah.
You should have the advantage in those types of matches versus any high agility ship should have a hard time against this list.
So it's a bump from that. There.
The thing is, because of just five of them, you have to fly, if you're the opponent, very carefully.
Yeah. Now, see, the number four, the TIE Advance number, Interceptor number four here, he's got wide open.
Yeah, he's going to want to go
three bank or hard three. Hard three, barrel roll, and then hopefully take some shots.
Yes.
So now that he's outside that group, he's got options, right?
He does.
He could, but...
Just down to nothing is the problem.
Yeah, he's down to nothing. So one or two bad primary weapon shots on him wins the game, right? Or loses the game for him, that is. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Yeah, but that very list you showed with, like, a fat Han would do really nice, I think, really nicely against this. You'd have to fly it carefully.
Yeah, and so you boost, you spank, and see now Y-Wings 1, 3, and 4 are just in a bad spot for the rest of the game.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, they're not going anywhere.
I mean, for now.
Yeah, this is like when you fly swarms of Z-95s, right? Mm-hmm. Like, they're a Z-95. Like, they're cheap and they kind of suck. The Y-Wing are great when you're in tight, but now you've got auto blasters and he's starting to get range.
It looks like he's just trying to fix his crit. Nope.
Not a bummer.
What crit is it?
Maybe a console fire?
Weapon.
So you're only firing two dice? That's rough. Hey. Oh, and we're at time, I guess.
Yeah, this will be ending soon, but I'm willing to bet they're going to call it soon.
Nice rolls. What app do you have that gives you the probability?
I have an app on my phone called, what is it called? XW Probabilities.
That's fantastic.
Which lets you put in, doesn't cover everything quite exactly, but it lets you put in number of attack dice and which mods you have versus number of defense dice and which mods you have. And it shows you the probability, the expected number of hits, and the probability of at least one hit.
That's pretty good.
Which is kind of neat.
Yeah. It's not bad.
Yeah. Which is where I realized that that 9-dice attack list, fully modified Nora 9-dice attack, can kill a defender in...
A single shot.
A single shot most of the time.
Dirty.
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 Such a good... Such a fun list.
And that's when R4-D6 Biggs goes...
Well, you kill Biggs in one shot.
No, because the R4-D6 is down to
two. Oh, right, R4-D6. Yeah.
You're like,
I mean, it's not
no.
a serious. It's not a serious list.
No, it's awesome though.
But it is.
It
is
silly, really funny.
That there's a couple. There's a couple ways to do it. One with cool hand, but that is a one-time only thing.
Yep.
It's cool time.
Is discard, yeah.
And but it has a slightly better follow-up because you can actually afford to put a turret onto the Hawk. onto Jan. The other version has Lando on Jan, and you just hope for the best that you get that evade.
I like it because of Lando.
Yeah.
I think with them, you just park them right here. Let's see. Devin's flying so much more. Like this.
No, but
I
this is so good, though, because where's he going, right? Like, if number two...
Bank over and boost.
Yeah, but then that's his only option, right? And he might not have done that fearing that he would have just gone forward.
But he needs to remember, like, Devin needs to remember, he doesn't have to worry about arc.
True.
Like,
well,
you can just park yourself 90.
Yeah.
And...
Actually, you know what? That would have been better. Good. If he'd just gone straight, as long as he made sure to not land on the rock, he would have covered off. He would have made it so that
right.
the number two had less places he could possibly go. And that's the one thing. I mean, Devin's doing extremely well, obviously. But that's the one thing he could be doing better is having a wider spread of these Y-wings.
And he doesn't fly a lot of his... he doesn't fly a lot of turreted ships.
Right.
Devin flies...
TIE Fighters.
TIE Fighters.
Oh, no. Well, you barrel roll back.
Yeah. Actually, you want to watch how you barrel roll, because if you barrel roll in, you're going to get auto-blasted.
Actually, I might stay there and
I
just
I would shoot
kill,
in a token. Yeah.
Yeah, take a token, kill number three, and I think you're out of range of one and four.
Yeah.
Number
four is going to get a shot, but it's if even
it'll
if you're
primaries.
In arc,
yeah.
He's unmodified, too.
Unmodified primaries, yeah. Number two is going to eat it this turn.
Yeah, he's dead. So he's dead.
Oh, no. I mean, it's possible Devin rolls poorly and doesn't get any hits.
Actually, a roll crit seems to be what Devin's doing.
Yeah, right?
Like, he's rolled a lot of crits. This is one of these reasons why you run, like, Drell or Fire. Right?
Yeah.
Where you're like, yes. Just spread
okay.
this fire out.
Hit crit. That's it. That's going to kill... That Y-wing.
Crit.
Number three is dead. Yeah. I don't see what crit that is, but it doesn't matter.
Actually, that was really...
Oh, major major explosion.
Good. He may have been in range one, too.
Well, I'm pretty... He was in range one of that guy.
That
I think
good.
He's outside range one
yeah.
of one and four.
That was good.
Yeah. Well positioned.
Now, the sad thing is number two is...
Number four has one hit left, though.
Yes. And focus for two. Dead.
Well, can a single TIE
with
interceptor
hit
with one hit point
range two.
Kill four Gold Squadron Y? Nope.
Hit crit.
Well, he's got three dice and a focus. He's fine.
Yeah.
Potentially.
Oh, definitely.
Ranks. Now he's good.
Yeah. When Rick has had to roll his green dice,
he's fine.
They've been pretty good, and they should be on an interceptor. He's rolling four dice a lot of the time.
I mean, eventually the dice will fail you though, and you will roll less than.
Yes.
Like if you take enough two dice primary shots, some are going to go through.
They'll chip in.
And he only needs one to go through, right? Whereas you need to save against all of them. So. Number four does a two forward, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Maybe even a three forward.
I'd be maybe actually banking out. Oh, let's see. Let me see what everybody else is doing.
So one does a hard two.
He's going to do a hard to get around. Like, he's going to want to start coming around with that. I might. Well, I don't know what the K turns on a Y-wing.
I think
but
it's
you
a
might
4K.
Want to K. If
yeah,
this,
I would just K turn. I would just K turn number two.
And then start coming around.
Yeah, see,
exactly.
Just two forward, right?
Because that.
Although this gives
in.
This gives him room to three bank and boost.
The reason why I was thinking bank on that was if he does like a 4-5 forward, it covers that, like right. It gets you the wider web.
Yeah. You know what? So I'm betting the interceptor's three banking, and then we'll boost. So I might actually have done a
1-4.
One forward with number two.
This isn't bad either, though.
Self-bumping so that he stays back. Oh, no, hard two. Okay, whatever.
He'll just turn it around, right?
Again, we're playing a little flat, fast, and loose. This is just an exhibition. We'll wait for the next round.
And Devin's blatantly cheating on stream.
What do we got? Hard three. Okay, yeah, that works too.
Sure.
Hard three. Actually, that's even a better choice than the three bank, really.
Right,
but now he has
back.
To boost.
Like, he is eating shots is the problem. Like, he has to boost to get out of auto blaster range. He has to boost that way,
forward?
To be honest. It,
no, oh, he could barrel roll, actually. Yeah, that's a good idea. That, I think,
that
takes
heads
him
up. That was good.
That's so close.
I thought that was really good.
Yeah, the barrel rolls.
If this does take him out, that was really good. I don't know if it does, though.
So, Interceptor has a shot on number 5. That's 2 hits, so 1 hit total. Number 5 takes 1. Oof.
The longest slog you'll ever.
And then, I think I was going for a laser.
If this weren't an exhibition, I would have called the judge.
Yeah, I would have called the judge. 2 hits, primaries.
Done.
Good game. There it is.